Hello everybody, today I'm going to show you how to create ASP.NET web forms using Visual Studio 2022. Before you start the video, please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you can get regular updates. So this particular project, we will use Visual Studio 2022 for this tutorial. So I will recommend, it's free. Of course, the community edition is free, so you can download it from Microsoft's site. Once you download, open it, you will see a screen like this. Click on create a new project. And here in this next screen, you will see all these templates which are available. So you will see all these templates. If you want to see more of the templates, you have to use the go to the Visual Studio installer, so which will be also installed as part of this. When you download and install Visual Studio, any Visual Studio tools, the installer gets installed on your system. So you can see here Visual Studio Community 2022, which I am going to use for this tutorial. If you go to modify here, so it will show you what is installed as part of this Visual Studio 2022, what are the components, libraries that are installed. So here you have to click this ASP.NET and web development, and I have also selected Azure development, so that will, if you want anything else, you can also select that, but these are the kind of minimum things that are needed for a .NET developer. I also do some mobile development, so that's why I have this installed as well. The .NET multi-platform app UI, which were previously known as Xamarin Forms, so that is also selected here. So you can select both these things, and as part of that, other components will get installed. Okay. In the individual components, also you can, if you want some additional frameworks, you can install those things. And here, some people may not get some of the older templates. So in that case, you have to the older .NET framework templates. In that case, you have to select this .NET framework project and item templates. Okay, so remember to select this, check this, and then install. So once you do that, if you go back here, so once you do that, you will get all the different .NET framework templates. All right. So .NET framework is the old framework. .NET Core is the latest framework, which is also called as .NET 6 or .NET 5. Yeah, they are calling it as .NET. So that is the latest framework. But the .NET framework is the older one. Okay. And the ASP.NET web forms, they will work with this .NET framework. Okay, it will not work with .NET Core. So now we are in the screen. So if you want to move ahead, then look for framework, and all the .NET framework supported templates are here. So if you select this, you can see here project templates for creating ASP.NET applications. You can create ASP.NET web forms, MVC, web API applications, all these things, right? So this is the template which you have to select if you want to create ASP.NET web forms. So I have selected this now, and click on next. So give some some project name. So let's say it is a web form demo project. Okay, so just select any location. So I have this to keep create all these demo projects at this location. So you can create your own location and store your files there. Click on create. Here in this window, this pop-up window will come up when you click on create, and here you can see different types of projects can be created. So I have selected web forms. So if you select web forms, then by default this web form will be selected. You can also use MVC and web forms. So in that case, you have to select this, and you can see MVC selected by default, and then you can select web forms. Okay, but if you want to go with the traditional approach, then select this web forms, leave all these things as it is, and click on create button. So it may take a couple of minutes, but within a couple of minutes it will create all the files and the project should be ready. Okay, so now the project has been created, and you can see all these files and folders. So all the webform projects have a .aspx extension. So you can see all the webform based pages, web pages will have this .aspx extension. And let's quickly go through some of the pages. So this is the default.aspx, which will be launched if you run it. So this is the first page you will see. There is the default.aspx. If I double click it, then it will show me the HTML code which is used to build this page. So this is the HTML code which is there inside this project, and then there will be a code behind, which is this aspx.cs. Let's double click this, and you can see that there is some C# code here. Okay, so, and this events are coming up here, page underscore load. You can add more events or methods you can add here in this page, and then you can add your logic using C#. Okay, and then there are some other default pages like contact, about.aspx, like this. Some default pages are there. There is this folder scripts, where you can see some JavaScripts. You can add all your, if you want, your own scripts. So basically create a folder, and then within that folder you store your JavaScript. Okay, then similarly all the fonts here in the fonts folder, bootstrap files and any style sheet files can be added here, content. Here there are two files called bundled config and route config. So this contains some routing logic, and then bundled config is used to bundle the pages, bundle the files. So this is the code which will create a bundle. So if you may have a lot of JavaScript files, so it will bundle all those files. So now then you have this app data folder. App data folder is where you can keep your data files, or database files can be stored in the app data folder. Then the references, it will be all the DLLs referred by the projects. Those will be here. And properties will contain assembly info. You can add some properties for your project, like the description, company name, all those things, or assembly version also you can specify here. So those properties goes into assembly info.cs file. So this is basically the structure of this. Now let's run it and see what happens. First we can build it, or you can directly run also. It will build and then it will run. So you can see that Microsoft Edge is selected. You can change the browser as well. But if I run this, it will open Microsoft Edge browser and render the page there. Okay, now the build is succeeded. So what I will do is I'll click on this run button. So it will take a minute or so, and then the browser should open up and the page should be rendered. So the, as I said, it will be the default.aspx page which will be rendered. So now it is trying to fetch that page. All right, so now you can see the default.aspx page has been rendered, and this is the asp.net web form. Here this is the default.aspx page, by the way, and here you can also see that there are some other pages like about, contact. So these pages are there. Okay, now let's do a bit of change here, do some changes to this page and see what happens. This is just for the demo purpose. I will do some changes. So here you can see some div there are some div elements, and there is some content. What I can do, I can actually show you how to add a new page. If you want to add a new page, just right click this and add, and here you can say there are these pages here. So there should be a web form page, and let's name it something, names. Okay, so this is my names .aspx. What I can do is can add hello here, the list of the names or the names. Okay, and we can add and use on Sam. So I have added three names. Now what I will do is create a link to this page. Go to default.aspx. Here I can add a link. Here I will say p, and then link page. Let's make this as a link if equal to, now I can select the names page here. Okay, so names.aspx. So now this will go to the, when you click on this names link, you the names page will be rendered. Okay, so let's build this, then let's rebuild this. So rebuild all succeeded. Now run it. Okay, so you can see that now the page has rendered, and this is the item which this is the line which I have added, link to the names page. So click on names, and you can see the names page has rendered here, and all the names which I have added are now listed here. You can do the styling, you can add header, footer, and you can do stylings here. Okay, more content, text, all these things can be added, which is pretty standard stuff. So this is for this tutorial. This is what I wanted to show, that this is how you can create a ASP.NET web form project using Visual Studio 2022. It supports it. Just you have to create based on the, you have to use the right template and select the right framework version, and then create this. I hope you have enjoyed this video. If yes, please hit the like button. Thanks for watching.